to wait for what I can't see now. Cause Lord, when I wait, well, it ain't about.
Thank you for calling God. If you wish to offer up a prayer of thanksgiving, please press
1.
There is currently
no.
Wait. If you wish to intercede on behalf of a friend or loved one, please press
2.
There is currently a
4-minute
wait. If you wish to offer God advice, please press
3.
There is currently a
lifetime
wait. If you wish to learn a complex theological concept just so you can impress your friends and feel really smart, please
hang up
and check your attitude. If you wish to learn patience, please
stay on the line.
If you wish to grow in your relationship with God or to simply enjoy His presence, please disregard this menu completely.
Hang up
and wait.
Lord, I will wait for what your love brings. Cause when I wait, you give me wings.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to worship here at the Fount in Fountain Valley, California. I am Pastor Glenn Hayworth, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to our service of worship today. We're so glad that you're joining us, and we're thankful for the opportunity to enter into your home or your place of work or wherever you are right now and to share this time of worship with you. We have a good service planned for you to celebrate the fruit of the Spirit called patience, and we'll be getting into that just in a moment. But let's first open our hearts to the Lord in prayer. Will you join me? Father, thank you for this opportunity to worship. Thank you for the technology that makes it possible, and thank you for the Spirit who permeates each and every one of us and who draws us into you and into your heart. Bless us today as we worship. Open our hearts and minds to all that you want to give us, all that you want to show us, and help us to please you by how we respond. We give you thanks and praise today in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen. All right, Christina is leading us in worship singing today, so let's join her.
Son of God was laid in dark. ground began to shake.
The ground began to shake. Stone was rolled away. This perfect love could not be overcome. Now death, where is your sting? Our resurrected King has rendered you
because of you. I thank you that you live in us and that we have your power in us, God.
We sing alleluia. We sing alleluia. We sing alleluia.
To praise him forever. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Let's sing this next song, Ever Be.
Your love.
set it up that we could have a relationship with you and that we get to be in your presence. God, we thank you so much. We thank you for your grace, God. We thank you for your mercy and all your goodness. This next song is Broken Vessels, and it's talks about God's grace, and it's the same words as Amazing Grace, the chorus. So let's just sing this together.
All these pieces broken and scattered in mercy. Thank you.
so much for who you are and what you did for us. We thank you for your grace that covers a multitude of sins, God. We thank you that we can come to you as we are and that you love us just the same no matter what we do. God, I pray that you'd be with us today, be with us the rest of this service, God, that we would just meet you and feel your presence today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Christina. All right, it is time to enter into a season of prayer, and I'll first invite you to spend a few moments in silent reflection as you consider how your life has measured up to the demands of God to walk in righteousness. So let us consider and contemplate our lives for just a moment. Lord, we confess that we have sinned and we have not lived up to the standards that you have placed before us in the life and person of Jesus. We have fallen short of your glory. We have not loved you with our whole heart, our whole mind, soul, and strength. And we have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. So forgive us, God. Cleanse us from our unrighteousness and help us to walk in holiness before you and before the world. As you set us free from the bondage of sin, help us to walk in that freedom. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. And let us now continue in our season of prayer as we lift up the concerns and joys of our hearts as we pray. Let us pray. Lord, as we come together as your people, we give you thanks for this blessing to come directly to you, to lift our hearts to you, to lay our lives before you, to say to you that we are helpless without you, and that with you we are able to accomplish all that you call us to accomplish, all that you want us to do. Thank you for that privilege. Thank you for that honor to walk and to be the people of Jesus. Today we lift up those whom we know to be ill or injured, and we pray for your healing today. We pray especially for Sylvia, that you would help her to feel well and to get back to full strength. We pray for her brother to walk again and for Jody to be healed from breast cancer. We pray for Karen, that you would continue to heal her. We thank you, God, that you're working your healing in her body, that she is getting stronger every day. We pray for Nina and for all of the health issues that she has been confronting recently, and pray for your healing touch. God, we're grateful for the opportunity to know and love people who walk with you and who honor you with their lives. Help us to show that love to others so that they too might be drawn into your family and to learn to walk in the ways of Jesus. We thank you for the ways in which you heal us when we are sick, when we are injured. We pray for those who are facing surgeries and ask that you would be with them for calm and peace. We pray for doctors and nurses who are treating the sick and the injured and ask that you guide their hands and give them wisdom in their treatments. We pray, God, that you would help us to honor the men and women that serve us locally as firemen and firefighters and as police officers, and pray that you would protect them and watch over them and keep them safe and help us to show them our gratitude for their service. For our elected officials, we pray for wisdom. We pray that you would help differing parties to come together for the common good and to come to compromise decisions that would move us forward. We pray for our church, our local church, as well as our denomination, and for the church universal. Pray that you help us to live together in unity, but also live together faithfully, honoring you and abiding by your word. Give us your peace as we seek your face in all things. God, help us to show your love to all people. Help us to honor our neighbors, our friends, every stranger that we meet. We pray for the men and women that serve us in military uniform throughout the world, and pray that you would protect them and watch over them and bring them home safely once their mission is complete. And we thank you for their willingness to serve and their willingness to sacrifice on our behalf. Lord, for all these things, we pray in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior, who taught us to pray with these words, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now I invite you to join me in reciting the Apostles' Creed, this great ancient creed of the Church, as we affirm our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. All right, it is time for the offering. And as we prepare to hear the offertory today by our choir, I invite you to support the ministries of the Fount, and we're grateful for your support. You can mail a check to the Fount at 18225 Bouchard Street, that's B-U-S-H-A-R-D Street, in Fountain Valley, California. The zip is 92708. You can also go on our website at thefount.church, click on the online giving tab and make your contributions that way. You can even point your camera at the QR code on the screen right now, and it will take you to a portal for making an online contribution. You can even text the word give to this number, 714-276-6340, and that will take you to a portal for making an online contribution. We're grateful for your willingness to support the church and its mission. You can even click on the link that is pasted right there in the comments section on Facebook Live. We make it easy to make your contributions. So thank you for your generosity. Thank you for your giving in Jesus' name. Now our choir is back, and they offer a special sharing of the Latin Ubi Caritas, where love and charity there, where love and charity are, there God is.
Oh,
Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the gifts of your people, for their generous hearts, and for their willingness to provide the necessary resources to keep the ministries of the Fount going, both locally here in Orange County and throughout the world. Bless them, bless the gifts, may they increase for the sake of the kingdom, and in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. All right, Autumn is going to do our children's song today. Here's Autumn and Christina.
Is anyone coming?
That's okay.
Oh, be careful, little eyes, what you see. Oh, be careful, little eyes, what you see. For the Father up above is looking down in love. So be careful, little eyes, what you see.
Oh, be careful, little hands, what you do.
Oh, be careful, little hands, what you do. Oh, be careful, little hands, what you do. For the Father up above is looking down in love. So be careful, little hands, what you do.
Oh, be careful, little heart, whom you trust.
Oh, be careful, little heart, whom you trust. Oh, be careful, little heart, whom you trust. For the Father up above is looking down in love. So be careful, little heart, whom you trust.
Oh, be careful, little feet, where you go.
Our first hymn, besides the entire hymn sing this morning, is number 455, Not So In Haste My Heart. If you are able, would you stand and join me in singing this hymn of the church?
Today is from James 5, verses 7 and 8. Be patient, therefore, beloved, until the coming of the Lord. The farmer waits for the precious crop from the earth, being patient with it until it receives the early and late rains. You also must be patient. Strengthen your hearts, for the coming of the Lord is near. God bless the reading of his word.
All right. Yes, God bless the reading of his word. You know, if we are growing in Christ, progressing in our walk with Jesus, the fruit of the Spirit will manifest in our lives. But if the fruit of the Spirit is not manifesting in our lives, then we need to re-examine our relationship with Jesus. We need to reconnect with the Holy Spirit, yielding our lives to Him so that we can produce the kind of fruit that we're talking about in this series, listed in Galatians 5, 22 through 23. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness or generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. So far, we've looked at love, the kind of love that is self-sacrificing, preferring the good of the beloved over the self, the kind of love that Jesus shows us, not the kind of love that's glorified in Hollywood. Then we looked at joy, which is contrasted with happiness. Joy transcends the circumstances of our lives, and it exists even in times of great trouble and distress. This is the kind of joy that knows that God's got this. Then we looked last week at peace. Like joy, peace is that calm assurance that no matter what is happening, God's got this. That God is ultimately in control, and that in the end, we will be all right. Today we turn our attention to the fourth fruit of the Spirit, which is patience. And this is probably the hardest one of all, with the possible exception of self-control. But if the Holy Spirit is at work in you, and you are yielding your life to Him through the spiritual disciplines and through serious discipleship, then the fruit of patience should begin to manifest in your life. If you are consistently in the Word, if your prayer life is solid and growing, and if you are moving on to perfect love or agape. If it isn't there, then you and the Lord have more work to do, which is true in me. And if you're like me, patience is difficult, to say the least. I am more likely to be impatient about almost everything than I am to calmly wait for the Lord to reveal and unveil. Take the current situation in our denomination, for instance. Had not the pandemic struck last year, the General Conference would have already met and acted on the protocol of separation, and we would be well on our way into a new era of ministry and vitality. But because of the pandemic, we are in a holding pattern. More and more frustrations are occurring. The impasse that occurred in our own annual conference involving three Korean pastors and their churches, which thankfully is mostly resolved now with the just thing happening for the most part. The situation right now in North Georgia with the wonderful church, Mount Bethel United Methodist Church, where Cindy and I attended the WCA Global Gathering back in 2018. The bishop there is trying to close this vital church and to take over its assets and buildings, all because it refuses to go along with her agenda to liberalize the conference. We need to keep Mount Bethel in our prayers, to be sure. And the situation in Holtville, California, the Imperial Valley east of San Diego, where our own bishop and district superintendent have closed a church and are now trying to repurpose its buildings to house a temporary shelter for immigrants trying to enter the U.S. as refugees from Mexico and Central America. The congregation at Holtville did not want to close their church, and they were willing to work at providing ministry for folks in their local community. But they were ignored, and the closure of their church went forward. Now they are meeting at the local women's club, reorganized as the First Church of Holtville, no longer a United Methodist Church. So many things are happening, and so quickly in our culture that it's really hard to keep up anymore. The changing social mores with regards to sexuality and gender, race and politics, it is getting more and more difficult to recognize our own country. And yet, in the midst of all this, we long for Jesus to return and to set everything right. Our text for today speaks to that angst from James 5, verses 7 and 8. Be patient, therefore, beloved, until the coming of the Lord. The farmer waits for the precious crop from the earth, being patient with it until it receives the early and the late rains. You also must be patient. Strengthen your hearts, for the coming of the Lord is near. Now the Greek word translated patience is makrothymia. It means a long holding out of the mind before it gives room to anger. Biblical patience is a God-exercised or God-given restraint in face of opposition or oppression, but it is not passivity. Someone has said, patience is a virtue that carries a lot of weight. Do you get it? Wait. W-A-I-T. Patience is a virtue that carries a lot of weight. Waiting. Waiting is an important spiritual value. We're told to wait on the Lord in too many to count passages of Scripture. The most familiar, perhaps, is from Isaiah 40, verse 31. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Now, few of us likes to wait, but we have to wait for a lot of things. And being impatient, as so many of us are, makes waiting all the harder. We have to wait for things like getting married or graduating, having that first child or grandchild, getting that promotion, waiting for a loved one to visit, retirement. The list goes on and on. But why is it so hard to wait? Our culture has become oriented to instant gratification. Amazon ships the very next day, and in some cases it can deliver on the same day that something is ordered. No more waiting a week or two or having to drive to the mall. We can look up any fact on the internet. No need to go to the library or call someone. We can listen to our favorite song instantly on Spotify or one of a few dozen other music apps, rather than waiting all day for it to play on our local radio station. Remember that? We can relate to Veruca Salt in Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, who says, "I want it, and I want it now!" That's kind of the heart of our culture, isn't it? And for me, impatience raises its ugly head most when I'm in a hurry to get somewhere. At times like this, it seems other people driving on the road are actually trying to slow me down or make me angry. Driving slowly, taking their time to turn, etc., my anxiety and my anger rises so quickly. Patience, someone has said, is something you admire in the driver behind you, but not in the one ahead. Here's one I'm sure you can relate to. You're in a hurry to get somewhere, and your wife or kids don't share your sense of urgency. There you are, waiting at the door or in the car for them to get ready to go. Now, what are you experiencing inside? Are you peacefully watching the wind blow the flowers gently back and forth in the garden? Do you pull out the owner's manual for the car and with great interest read about the option on your car that you didn't even know you had? Or are you in a somewhat different frame of mind? Do you find yourself asking, what is more important, being late or the people I am waiting for? If God can watch us destroy ourselves and His creation and peacefully sit back, perhaps we can show a little more patience when things are not going quite as we planned. You might be amazed at what God gives you when you peacefully wait rather than stress out and get angry. Maybe it's a spiritual opportunity that you would not have had otherwise. This is something I know in my head, but that I don't always practice. How about you? Proverbs teaches or reminds us in Proverbs 19:11, those with good sense are slow to anger. It is their glory to overlook an offense. So patience involves not only waiting, but also not taking up an offense. Patience usually connotes a calm, abiding endurance, sometimes associated with wisdom or humility. It means one doesn't get too upset about things, but calmly and with an abiding hope, lets things unfold in their own time. It's why the translation of long-suffering is a good one. Paul talks about the relationship of hope with patience in Romans 8, verses 24 and 25. For in hope we are saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope, for who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Patience is the appropriate response as we deal with one another. Paul says in Colossians 3, verse 12, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. And in 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 14, he says, "And we urge you, beloved, to admonish the idlers, encourage the faint-hearted, help the weak, be patient with all of them." And with respect to those who are new believers or pre-believers, 2 Timothy 4:2 says, "Proclaim the message, be persistent whether the time is favorable or unfavorable, convince, rebuke, and encourage with the utmost patience in teaching." Because our model is the Lord himself, about whom Paul says in Romans 2, verse 4, "Or do you despise the riches of his kindness and forbearance and patience? Do you not realize that God's kindness is meant to lead you to repentance?" And Peter joins in 2 Peter 3, verse 9, "The Lord is not slow about his promise, as some think of slowness, but is patient with you, not wanting any to perish, but all to come to repentance." And as James says in our text for today, the farmer waits for the precious crop from the earth, being patient with it until it receives the early and the late rains. You also must be patient. It isn't easy, but it is a fruit of the Spirit. And do you see the overlap? That love is the foremost fruit of the Spirit, and it powers all of them. Through love, we experience joy by allowing the love of God to permeate our whole being. And with love permeating us, we find peace in the Lord, the calm assurance that God is God and we are not. And with peace, we find patience that allows us to rest and trust that God is in control. Next Sunday, we'll have the special blessing of hearing a guest preacher here at the Fount. My wife, Cindy's cousin, Bud Brainerd, a retired pastor, who, along with his wife, recently moved to Southern California, Bud will be preaching from Romans chapter 1, verses 1 through 17, and his sermon is titled, A Handful of Truths. I'll be here, though, because we're going to be celebrating Colleen Kay, who just retired from being our preschool director. So it'll be a big Sunday, and I'll be looking for you, either in person at 10 o'clock or here online at noon. And then the following Sunday on August 1st, we'll continue this series on Fruit of the Spirit with kindness. Kindness is our next Fruit of the Spirit. Now let's spend a few moments in prayerful reflection as we consider what God is speaking to our hearts today.
Just wanted to add one thing. The last thing, oh, thank you. The last thing he said was, in patience, we have to trust the Lord. And in Proverbs 3, it says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart." And then there's the part that we don't like. "And lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him, and he will direct your paths." So this book is filled with promises, and all we have to do is trust him, but that's a lot. Easier said than done. But with that, let's sing the closing hymn, "Be Still My Soul," number 534 in the hymnal. Please stand.
Still my soul, the Lord is on our side.
Thank you for joining us today here at the Fount for our Sunday worship on July the 18th. It is always good to be with you, and we hope that you'll join us again next Sunday at the same time, 12 noon Pacific Daylight Time, here on Facebook Live. Until then, may the Lord bless you and keep you in all ways as you go forth in this week. Bless you. Bye-bye now.